Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this Photoshop tutorial, I will show you how to take a photo of a person and make that person's head shiny and blue. Similar to the Blue Man Group entertainers, usually you will apply this to a picture of a bald man, such as Bruce Willis, Patrick Stewart, or Dwayne Johnson. Load in the Bruce Willis picture. The link is in the description area. Press Ctrl-J to duplicate the background layer. Use the Quick Selection tool, size 20, Auto Enhance On, to make a selection of the face and neck. An area to watch is on the left collar. We need to manually select which area is his neck versus which is the neck shadow on the inside of his collar. While the marching ants are showing, press Q to activate the quick mask. Select the brush tool at 50% hardness. Make sure your foreground color is white so that you can paint out the selection that is not the neck in this area. Now switch the brush color to black and paint back in areas of his neck that are not selected. When satisfied, press Q again to show the revised marching ants. Press Ctrl-J to copy the selection to a new layer. Name it Skin. Temporarily turn off the bottom background layer. Add a new layer on top. Name it Shine. Make the skin layer active and Ctrl-click it. Choose Select Color Range. Choose Highlights. Change the selection preview to Black Matte and move Range to the right where the highlights look shiny. For this image, I use a range of 217 and a fuzziness of 0. When satisfied, click OK to make the selection. Make the shine layer active. Change the foreground color to B8CAF5. Then Alt Backspace to fill the shine layer with a light blue shine color. Press Ctrl D to deselect. Select the skin layer. Add a blue color fill layer. Number 336, 3DC. Above the skin layer, flip it to the skin layer, and make its blend mode multiply. You should notice a light colored outline around the face. This is the blurred edges of the original face. The original image has the background blurred by either the camera or by software, which makes selecting the subject difficult, as both Bruce and the background have a little of each other in them. This becomes especially apparent after we apply the blue fill layer, blended with Multiply. I found the easiest way to remove it was by using Content Aware to remove the head on the original image. Make the background copy layer 1 active. Use the polygonal lasso tool to make a selection of the head as shown. Enter Edit, Fill, and Fill with Content Aware. There is a little problem where his right collar touches his neck. To fix it, turn off the eye of the skin layer and use the stamp tool to remove some brown from the suit onto the area needed. Now turn back on the skin layer. We need to touch up the shine layer to remove tiny highlight spots that are unnecessary. select the shine layer. Add a layer mask to it and use a black brush to remove most of the tiny bright spots as demonstrated. I've sped up the video to save time. You can also use the lasso tool to select areas of spots to fill with black to remove them. I've read that the Blue Man Group players apply a thin layer of wax to fill in the pores of their skin before putting the rest of the makeup on. Select the skin layer and make it a smart object. Then apply a 4-pixel median blur to it to smooth things out a little. Add a vibrance adjustment layer to the color fill layer. Click the Clip To icon. I use the setting of Vibrance 44 and Saturation 44. Next, we'll work on the eyes. Temporarily turn off the Vibrance and Color Fill layers to see everything better. Make the skin layer active. Zoom in on the eyes. Press Q to activate the Quick Mask. Use a soft black brush to paint over the eye whites and corneas of the eyes to make a selection of them. Press Q to see the selection. Now press Ctrl J to make a new layer. Name it Eyes. Move the new layer to the top. Turn on the Vibrance and Color Fill layers. Now add a Vibrance Adjustment layer to the eyes. Click the Clip To icon and use the settings of Vibrance -33 and Saturation -53. Now zoom in to the teeth. Select the skin layer again. Turn off the Vibrance and the Color Fill layers. Press Q to start the Quick Mask. Paint over the teeth with the same black brush. I've sped up the video to save time. When done, press Q again. Then Ctrl J to copy the selection. Name the new layer Teeth and move it below the Eyes layer. Turn back on the Vibrance and Color Fill layer you turned off earlier. Add a Vibrance Adjustment layer to the Teeth layer. Click the Clip To icon and use the settings of Vibrance -8 and Saturation -24. To reclip the Vibrance and Color Fill layers, select the Vibrance layer, then hold down the Control or Command key and select the Color Fill layer. Then right-click and choose Create Clipping Mask. Next, we'll fix a spot where the left collar meets the neck by using the Stamp tool on Layer 1. Remove the rogue shine on the shirt by painting black in the shine mask. We need to change the light shadows on the white shirt to a bluish color. Select layer 1. Add a Hue Saturation Adjustment layer. Click the Colorize box. Make the settings U238, Saturation 29, and Lightness -4. Close the Properties box. Select Layer 1. Now use the Quick Selection tool to select the white shirt areas only. While you have the marching ants selected, invert the selection by pressing Shift-Control-I. Change the foreground color to black. Now click the Use Saturation Mask and press Alt-Backspace to fill the mask with the inversed area so only the shirt will show through. You can now use white and black brushes on the mask to touch up as needed. For the final touch-up, we will add some vibrance to the clothes and background. The layer 1 U in saturation should still be active. Add a vibrance adjustment layer to it. Set the vibrance to plus 46 and the saturation to plus 46. This concludes the tutorial. Thanks for watching.